Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today I will be trying to renovate the Bloxburg starter house, but I can't add or delete any of the walls, so I'm gonna have to build the house just the way it is without changing anything. But I think it's fine. I kind of wanted an open layout, like the way the living room and the dining table and the kitchen are all together in one spot. I don't think, even if I could, I would have added walls, so I don't think this is too much of a challenge for me. But I think I might have wanted to change the layout of the house itself, but I guess it's okay that I can't, and I'm hoping I can. I started struggling here because I don't know how to do paths well. I'm trying to learn, but like, it's kind of difficult, but I just did a simple one leading from the door to the sidewalk, and I think it turned out fine. Struggled with the gardening here as well because I didn't want to add too much gardening as it is a starter home, so obviously it's not meant to have too much, but I added like one or two trees and a little garden as well, which should show up soon. For the interior, I try to keep kind of the same layout. I didn't change too much about the layout, but obviously I went with kind of like a modern sort of theme, the same way the exterior was, but I don't know if I like used modern the correct way, but I kind of like the way it turned out. Thank you. here I decided to add a little island. I was hoping that it would look nice, and I honestly think it did. I'm really glad I added it, and I think it really added something to the build. I decided to keep the iconic Bloxburg starter house bookshelf beside the couch because it's iconic, basically. I just gave it a little upgrade, added my own custom books that match the color scheme, and I added a few plants for decoration. Oh, I also kept the little light that they put, but I just changed it. Thank you. bathroom is a bit smaller than I would have wanted. I would have definitely extended the bathtub slash shower a bit back and had more room for a sink. But for the space I had, I really liked the bathroom and I don't think I did a bad job. For this bedroom, I'm actually really proud of it because this is like the best bedroom I've built because I wanted to like test my building skills, and I used this renovation as a way to test it. And normally I never use patterns on the inside at all unless it's like the flooring, so I'm really glad that I tried out some new patterns and I think it works really well with the room. Testing out a hack which I saw some other YouTubers do where they change paintings to headboards to make it look as if there's something behind the bed, and honestly I didn't think it would work out well, but it worked really well, and you guys should definitely try this hack out as well. For the closet, you'll find out later in the video that I placed it on the wrong side, but you know, we can ignore that, just carry on. Thank you. So that's the end of the video, but overall, I think I did pretty well for someone who's still not that good at building, but I want to know what you guys think, so leave that in the comments below. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoy this video. Also, really make sure to subscribe because I'm almost at 200, and I would absolutely appreciate it if you guys could get me to 200. But thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!